إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. يا رب لك الحمد، أنت نور السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، أنت الحق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والجنة حق والنار حق. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا رسول الله، نشهدك يا ربنا أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله تعالى به عن هذه الأمة الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فاللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره وسار على دربه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة في دين الله بدعة. أما بعد، فيقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز: وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. مادر بدان سيسا الإسلام جمعة بركة الله فيه ويالله بسلو فيه إن شاء الله. I just want to put one question to all of us: why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all of us? Your answer is ready already. You will say yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship him. Right? Yes. Nowadays, if you ask someone who is running business, for example, and you ask him, what is your plan to educate yourself and learn about Islam and about your kids? What is your plan? He say, actually, I'm now very busy in my project and my business. I have big deal. Inshallah, when I finish it, I will think about what you are saying. This is a, like normal answer. Why? Because he can have 100% of concern on his job, on his business, 100%. Although my question in the beginning, what I said, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us? And your answer is to worship him. To worship him. But reality is opposite. What are we focusing on? A person focusing on his business. If he is a businessman, is mashallah spending much and much and much time for his business. Focus on his business. So you ask him, what is your plan to learn Quran? To learn your aqidah? To learn about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his seerah? And to educate your kids and your wife? He say, yes, inshallah, I have plan. I have something in my mind. When you will start? You say, inshallah, just I need some time to finish my business, to finish my deal, then inshallah, I think I will start. And this is that kind of thinking until he finish his life. I'm not learning anything. If I ask many of us here, with my full respect, can you tell me about Arkan al-Wudu, for example? All the Arkan. And Arkan al-Salah, the pillars of Salah, from the beginning until the end, I'm not sure that all of us can give correct answer. Although, Salah is a pillar in Islam, not something like we can discuss later. No, no. It's a pillar. You are performing 5 times a day prayers, right? Although, not all of us can know what is sunnah in Salah and what is wajib. Not all of us. But if I ask you about your business, oh, mashallah, like perfect answer. Perfect answer. So again, our question is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. And the answer is to worship Him. So are we really doing our best to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that have that kind of qualification and education to worship Him by the correct way? This question needs big answer from every one of us, starting from me. You, when you leave the masjid, think about this question, inshallah. Answer yourself. You answer yourself, and it's not my job. You answer yourself. And what you will do after that, it's you. Same category of people, like if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them, alhamdulillah, much money, much wealth, and you can give one question, brother or sister, did you like have a plan or put a plan to help the needy people? Same answer almost. I have plan, I have deal, I have business. Inshallah, when I finish, when I success, I think inshallah I will give some money for needy people. When I finish. Not now, no, no, no. When I finish. That kind of answer. Same question if you ask a people who has like high position, high rank. What is your plan to serve Islam? What is your plan to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to learn about Islam? Same answer. My position is very sensitive. Inshallah, when I retire, like 60 or 65 years old, I think, inshallah, I will think about coming to the mosque. I will think about coming to learn and do my best, inshallah. Did I say anything wrong? Was this our reality? Unfortunately, I'm speaking about our reality, right? So is that suitable for us as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And remember our answer again. We answered all of us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Him. So now we need to understand the real meaning of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantee for all of us our rizq. He said to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, إِنَّ لَكَ أَلَّا تَجُوعَ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْرَى وَأَنَّكَ لَا تَظْمَأُ فِيهَا وَلَا تَضْحَى. Your rizq already written. Something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed to you until your last day in this life. But what we are doing, we are giving 100% focus on the thing already guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Already guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the thing which is our main duty to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we put it in the corner. Is it suitable to us as a Muslims? I will give you one example, inshallah, to make it clear for you. Clear, inshallah. Let's assume that there is a president in the country and he appointed you to go to another country for official mission, official like job, okay? You will do something and you come back to your country. You now, official person, has been sent by the president of your country to another country. And you are now representing your country. What is expected that the ambassador of your country will receive you there and will do his best to give you the best hospitality and best place, accommodation, food, even big salary, of course. But why all of these things? Because you are representing your country and you have main and official duty and job. Remember, you have main duty, official job to do in that country. Right? That's why your president do his best to make you like feel comfortable and support you by every like available thing to do your job perfectly. Let's now imagine that the person who has been appointed and went to that country and he's received everything, money, hospitality, and everything, he didn't do his job. He didn't do anything. He just spent his time to enjoy that kind of food and money and hospitality and high rank and photo with this and this. How the president will look at that person? He's a cheater, right? He's cheating the president. He's cheating all his country, right? Why? Because he has official like mission, duty, but he didn't do anything. Although they give him all what he need, even more, etc. Money, position, famousness, everything. But he didn't do his job. That person is not a good citizen, right? And of course, the president or that responsible person will never, ever ask him again to do any other job again. Why? Because he already breaks the trust. He already breaks the trust. Now I think the example is close to your mind to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you Khalifa in this earth, right? He created you and he made you master of all the creation, right? And he give you everything. He guarantee all your risk and this all nature for you. Everything for you. Why? To worship him. But what we have done? What we have done? We didn't do anything except focusing on something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already granted and we ignore the main thing. This is our reality now. That's a question we need to think about it. Why we are thinking by this way, how to fix that kind of way. Actually, most of the answer when the person say, inshallah, I will finish my like project and my dreams and inshallah, after retirement, I will stay in the masjid all the day. I will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the day. It seems like if someone, for example, is professional in football, for example, his like club, or his like team need him while he is young or after his retirement. As a player, I'm not saying as a coach, as a player. They need him when he is very powerful and fully talented or after he becomes very weak. Young, of course. Young, of course. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you time, money, and strength and power and everything. And you want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you become very old. And put all your power and time and everything for your business. Is it acceptable? Do you think really is acceptable towards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you think by this way, of course no. Inshallah we continue after second khutbah. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله الصادق الوعد الأمين عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المذنبة بتقوى الله تعالى. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم لو كان لابن آدم واديان من ذهب لابتغى ثالثهما. Now let's think about why people think by this way, as I mentioned in the first khutbah. Let's analyze that kind of statements. First of all, when a person say that, inshallah, after my retirement, I will do my best to learn about Islam and Aqidah and Seerah and all of these things. Who told you that you will live until that time? Maybe now, while I'm giving khutbah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take my soul and I will die. Now, Allahu alam. I think maybe most, many of you saw many video that some, many imams giving khutbah and they passed away on the minbar, right? We don't know when we will die. Are you sure that you will leave from this mosque alive? Allahu alam. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no, not you. So death everywhere and decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who told you that you will reach that age and then you start to make tawbah or start to do your best in ibadah? Who told you? Are you sure about that? No one of us sure. كل نفس ذائقة الموت أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. الله أعلم when we will die. No one of us knew. This is the first point. Second, why most of us giving priority for the things as I mentioned, which is already guaranteed by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, guaranteed by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and we are ignoring the things which is already our main job. So why you are not doing opposite? Why you are, for example, study and you do your best in Islam and do a little bit for business? Why not of some of us thinking by this way? Why opposite? Why saying, no, I have to do my best in business only, take care of my deals and these things, right? And in maybe in 30 minutes, I will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why not opposite? Who give you that kind of thinking that you must think about that and ignoring the main job? Third, actually, when you think about worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and learning about Islam, it's serving your life, not only about hereafter. It's for you, for your life. Why? If you are working normal job and you don't know anything about Islam, for example, Islam teach us if you work for 8 hours, for example, you must work for 8 hours, not 7. Either if your boss watching you or not. This is Islam. But if a person doesn't know that kind of meaning and you already his boss, you will suffer from him because he is not honest in his job. If Islam say, don't deal with interest, but he doesn't know that, he will make major sin. If Islam said, Ad-Din is al-akhlaq. Actually, our Islam is akhlaq. 90% of our deen is akhlaq. If that person didn't learn from Islamic knowledge about akhlaq, how he will do, how he will deal with you and other people, either in his normal life or his job. What I mean, if you learn about Islam, it's not only about hereafter. Actually, everything for you, to fix you, to upgrade your level, to improve you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need anything from you, actually. You need him. You need to worship him for you, for yourself. Same, if you isolate the Islamic knowledge or Islamic learning from your normal life, it seems like someone making food, preparing food, without adding salt, without adding any salt. And then he brought that food in some plate and salt in another plate. And say, you must eat from this food without salt. And then after finish, you eat from the salt. Does it make sense? No. Does it make sense? No. Same. You want to isolate Islam from your normal life. Islam from your normal life. If a person isolates Islam from his normal life, he will be very far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his practice will be very, very far away from Islam and as a true Muslim, and many bad things will happen from his side. Then after that, after his retirement, becomes 65 years old, he say, now I will start inshallah to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While he even can't walk, or can't memorize, or can't understand, or can't do anything. I think about some people, not everyone. Not everyone. So is that not acceptable? So what we need to understand now, my conclusion in like last few minutes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, created us to worship him. So you need to understand that you need to focus on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before your life, before your business, before your normal matter. Not opposite. This is the real meaning of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, we are just wasting our time, and in the last maybe 1 year in our life, we say, okay, now I will start to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not acceptable. This is not acceptable. Mix Islam with your normal life, because everything in your life related to Islam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Everything in your life related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the real meaning to understand that kind of conception. You think that dunya is related to you and deen related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like as we say in Arabic, أَعْتِمَا لِكَيْسَرْ لِكَيْسَرْ وَأَعْتِمَا لِلَّهِ لِلَّهِ, which mentions the Bible, right? Give to the emperor what is related to him, and give to the God what is related to him. We are not Christian, we are Muslims. Who created that emperor? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even that emperor belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how you will give him what is belonging to him only in this dunya and separate that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's impossible. Both are related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either your normal life or worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because I just think, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Everything you are doing in your life related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's my message to you today. Again, ask yourself when you leave this mosque inshallah, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me? And I'm really doing my job, doing my duty as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? I'm doing balance between my normal job and being a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? This question not mine. I answer myself, you also answer yourself. Between you and yourself. Not between you and me or any other person. Between you and yourself. Not with any other person. So also I need to answer this question for myself. You also answer for yourself. Put a plan for yourself. We are now in non-Muslim country. We are now in a Muslim country. Are we educating ourselves to be good worshippers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by good way or not? How many things you learn about Islam? How many things you learn about Islam? I'm speaking at least about the five pillars of Islam. Shahadatain, the real meaning of La ilaha illallah and Muhammad Rasulullah. Do you know the real meaning of that? Do you know the meaning of performing five prayers a day? Do you know what is that meaning? Can you pray by correct way as Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, which is written by four mazahib? Can you do it? Do you know what is the ahkam of tahara, salah, and wudu, and all of these things? Did you learn anything, all of these things, or not? If you miss, it's not something good, because it's something related to the five pillars of Islam. Do you know about zakah? How to pay zakah? Do you know every hukm and every mas'ala about zakah? This is the pillars of Islam. Did you learn or not? Did you learn about siyam? And what is the case if my siyam is acceptable or not? What is the case if my siyam already break or not? Did you learn? Did you learn about hajj? Inshallah, next month, inshallah. Did you learn about that? I'm speaking about only five pillars. I'm not speaking about accurate knowledge in Islam. I'm speaking about the like minimum things which every Muslim must learn it. Every Muslim must learn it. Do you now have the ability to recite Surah Al-Fatiha without mistake? I give you something else. Do you know that every Muslim obliged to recite Surah Al-Fatiha correctly without any mistake? Do you know that? Tajweed, to learn Tajweed of Quran. Yes, not every Muslim can learn Tajweed. I know. This is about any other part separate than Fatiha. But Surah Al-Fatiha, every Muslim are obliged to recite Surah Al-Fatiha without mistakes. Why? Because you are reciting Surat Al-Fatiha in every prayer. If you know Sunnah prayer, Fard prayer, Qiyamul Layl, in every rak'ah, you are reciting Surat Al-Fatiha. That's why all the scholars have consistency. You must recite Surat Al-Fatiha without any mistake. Did you learn or not? You did your best and efforts for that or not? That's what I'm meaning. I'm not saying I want all of us to be scholars. This is not the purpose of my khutbah. I'm saying every Muslim need to learn the main things in his life as a Muslim. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the correct way. By Allah, how many people of you now hear about this statement? Every Muslim are obliged to learn Surah Al-Fatiha and recite it without any mistake. How many people? By Allah, ask yourself, did you hear this statement before? Since you are adult, until the last day in your life, you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and performing the five pillars of Islam. About prayer, salah, fatiha, how many times did you learn about reciting it? And about other things, like can you give me the difference between rukn, like pillar, and sunnah? And if I forget pillar while I'm praying, what should I do? And if I forget sunnah, what should I do? Right? I'm not saying all of these things to challenge you. I'm just opening my mind and your mind, my heart and your heart to do our best to learn the basics about Islam. As you are doing your best to study primary school, junior high school, and high school, and university, and some of you, bachelor degree, master degree, PhD. Why? Because you have targets. You have targets. You want to reach that level of education and position. Same, do you have target to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala satisfied on you? And if you, how he will be satisfied on you? If many of us doesn't even know the basics of Islam, basics. Wallahi, that happened to me before. I asked some of our brothers before, how many pillars in Islam? He said three. Can you imagine? Three. Pillars of Islam. The hadith which every one of us memorized when he was young. Bunya al-Islamu ala khams. He said three. I said even mention these three, he couldn't. He said, reciting Quran. He think reciting Quran is a pillar of Islam. Can't even know what is the meaning of Quran and what is the meaning of pillar of Islam. That's my small advice and humble advice to all of you inshallah. عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا برحمتك فيمن توليت وبارك لنا اللهم فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في فلسطين اللهم تقبل قتلاهم في الشهداء اللهم تقبل قتلاهم في الشهداء اللهم تقبل قتلاهم في الشهداء اللهم داوي جرحاهم اللهم داوي جرحاهم اللهم داوي جرحاهم اللهم عليك باليهود الملاعين اللهم عليك باليهود الملاعين اللهم عليك باليهود الملاعين اللهم احصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم احدا اللهم أرنا فيهم يوما أسودا كيوم عاد وثمود اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة